my name is Sofya Dolotovskaya, and I've just defended my PhD a few days ago at the Department of Behavioral Ecology and Social Biology at the DPZ. My most recent paper that just got published is about genetic monogamy in titi monkeys, and also about the process of mate choice, which is how do animals choose their mating partners. Animals or humans can live together, but it doesn't necessarily mean that they have offspring only with each other, because they can also mate with other males or females and still live together, so be socially monogamous, but not be genetically monogamous at the same time. So most of the animals, and especially most of the mammals, they are not monogamous. So it's very interesting to study monogamy to see how humans evolved to be monogamous. I specifically studied titi monkeys because titi monkeys are this classical textbook example of a monogamous primate, because they are pair living. So I conducted my research to see if they are also genetically monogamous. I've heard that they are called titi monkeys just because they make this vocalization when they are a bit nervous, and when they see the observers they make this titi titi titi. So probably it's that, but I'm actually not sure. And also they have this very cute habit of intertwining their tails, so they sit together and then they intertwine their tails like this. I went to our biological station in Peru, and there I spent two field seasons, 7 months each, and I was following titi monkeys, and we were collecting GPS locations of the groups to know what is their home range. And also I was collecting behavioral observations to see, do they cross the border of their home range to maybe mate with the neighbors, which would mean that they are not monogamous. And I collected fecal samples for genetic analysis, and then I used these fecal samples to genotype all my study animals. We can get a genotype, which is basically a unique DNA fingerprint that each animal has. And then when we compare this pattern, we can see which animal is more related to another one. And then we use those fingerprints also to do the parentage analysis. And this analysis is the same that we do in humans. So in this paper, I found first that the animals in my study population are genetically monogamous, which is really interesting because genetic monogamy is a really rare phenomenon among mammals. And then also we showed that the animals don't seem to use relatedness as a criteria to choose their partners. We don't really know if titi monkeys can recognize their relatives or no, but the relatedness between pair mates was on average still very low, despite the absence of active inbreeding avoidance. And we think that it might have to do with the habitat where they live being undisturbed, which gives them enough opportunities for dispersal. And this keeps the level of inbreeding quite low, and this helps to maintain genetic monogamy.